morning. Welcome to the Daily Connection.
Well, good morning, Genesis Valley, and welcome to another day of broadcasting right here at WDJL, your gospel explosion station. And we made the connection with the right time. I'm talking about with Dr. Mark Ferris at Christ in Action. We got him. Good morning, Pastor.
Good morning. Well, we fell back, but we got up, and it's a great day to be alive in the Lord. We call it a Super Sunday because we're connected to God and His Word, looking for super things today.
And you are so right. Some fell back, and some didn't get back up. I know, I'm a witness.
Yes, sir. Well, there's just one thing to follow that up with is the scripture from Ephesians that says, "Awake thou that sleepest, and Christ shall give thee light." Well, I tell you what, it's a great day to be alive in the Lord as we're all waking up on a different schedule. But hey, God is great. He is good. And you know what? The sun got up, talking about not just the sun over the horizon, but the Son of the living God, who in order to save us, in order to save the day, because of love, put himself in harm's way. Let me just tell you right up front, we're gathering at 10:30 today at the Holiday Inn Mid-City, calling all from this region and roundabout to gather, and we're going to do a wisely designed gathering opportunity for fellowship as we come together. As we do so, we're going to provoke one another to love and good works as we are kicking off the series, Power, as we're talking about God's power for our lives. And so we invite you, love to see you there, 10:30. Of course, we'll be online. Connected Church will be online as well if you're not able to attend in person. But hey, we're talking about power. That's our series for this season, this time. And I want to just jump it off, continuing. I began to introduce it yesterday. But, you know, everything that we consider and think about should be shaped by God's design, pattern, and original intent. How did he start it? What was his purpose, his plan, his design? This will help us to navigate the course of life and the things that we see in front of us so that we are not overwhelmed and overcome by them. And we know, as they used to say, we have a God who sits high and looks low. But not only does he sit high and look low, but for all of those who embrace him, he comes to live on the inside of us, as was his original design intent. With that said, you know, in the beginning, Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, that God said, "Let us make man in our image and likeness." And the first thing he said after that is, "Let them have dominion." That is so key. Please don't sleep on that truth, because what he announced from the very beginning is that you and I were created to have authority, to have the right, the designated, delegated authority to exercise influence and power in this earth, in this world. You know, as we look at the things going on around us, oftentimes we may feel powerless against things that we see around us. However, we are stilled and called and summoned to a place of being a difference that makes a difference when we understand this simple truth that when God created mankind, male and female, in his image and likeness, he said, "Let them have dominion." God never changed his original design. You know, you've heard this said before, the gifts and callings of God are without repentance. Well, so is that calling. That calling for you and I to be those who are ruling in this earth, in this world, as his delegated, designated representatives. Of course, that dominion begins with the dominion that you have within your own self as governed and granted by God. That dominion is the power of your decision, your choice to embrace God's design for you, to believe what he says about you, and to allow him to work in and through you in your everyday life. Yes, that's God's design for us. The power of God that works in us is his own will. Philippians chapter 2 and verse 13 says that it is him who works in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Note that he wills in us what he desires for us, but then also he works to do it, brings the power and ability and force of his influence and power to do the things that he brings into our hearts to will. Friend, that's the life that we were designed for from the very beginning. Now, we're going to talk more about this as we go on this month, but you are created for authority. No matter what's happened to you, what's happened in your life, or where your life stands today, the high call of God for your life is a place of dominion, ruling, first of all, in your own spirit, in your own heart and life, as you decide to surrender to his work and will in you. But then, having surrendered to him, to allow his will and work in and through your life, to change your atmosphere, to change your environment, as he works in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Hey, we love to see you at 10:30 today as we continue to unpack this subject. This has been an outreach of Connected Church. Connect with us, connected-church.com. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, wherever we can get the word out. And of course, right here on this Gospel Exposures outreach to the Tennessee Valley every single day, where the word of God is declared. God himself is exalted in his love for you. Pointed out all the time that your faith might rest in him and his love for you. The identity that we have in him, that together we are the difference that makes the difference that God intends, we desire and the world needs as we awaken to his purpose of knowing him and his love for us, mobilize his mission of making him known and sharing his love with others. That's good news on this Super Sunday fallback morning.
All right, Pastor. That's what I'm talking about. Man, people love that word you use then. Fallback. We want to let people know it's now 7:10, not 8:10.
That's it.
Yeah, all right. And we appreciate you, Pastor.
All right. Well, have a great day, sir. Thank you for what you do for us all day long. Have a great day now. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Hey.
All right. Hey, you're made for dominion. You're made for dominion. And understanding God's intent and design for that and embracing it for our lives allows him to be who he is in us and work in us to will and to do of his good pleasure. Say, hey, listen, for all of you all who are in the Huntsville, Madison, and surrounding areas, we'd love to see you at 10:30. We're going to meet you, greet you, love on you, teach you the word of God, and look for God's great power to confirm his word. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again real soon. Bye-bye.